please just stop. If you're still trying to work out how to make money online, do yourself a favor and quit. You don't need to work out how to make money online in this day and age. There's so many people out there who have worked this out for you, and you can buy the businesses that they have created that are already making passive income. So check this out. This website is for sale. It's yourtechbro.com, and it's already making passive income each month. On average, it's making $1,351 per month in income. So if you scroll down, I want to show you the proof of the traffic it's making. This is the proof of the traffic it's making. You can see the traffic from October 2020 to September 2021 has grown significantly, okay? And then let's check out the proof of income. So here's screenshots of the Amazon affiliate account, Amazon Associates account. Now, when they started monetizing this, or from the 12-month period, $178 they were making per month in October 2020. Now they're making an average of around $1,350 in passive income. In September, you can see they made this much. They had two really good months in March and also in April. So here is a website you can actually buy that's making about $1,500 per month on average and making a net profit of $1,350 net profit in passive income per month. How cool is that? This is the path to the 4-hour work week. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to buy this business and make over $1,000 per month, or buy any other business that's already making that passive income. And make sure you stick around, or even jump ahead if you like, but whatever you do, make sure you catch my advice on how I've been able to help people save thousands to tens of thousand dollars off the price of the businesses that they've bought. Personally, I've helped over 300 people to buy websites and grow them from 4 figures per month to 5 figures and even 6 figures per month. And through the tens of thousands of businesses that I've looked at, I've worked out the easiest formula to buy these content websites. And I'm gonna share with you how to do this right now. Step number one is, first, you need to find the website businesses that you want to purchase. Now, we do have many places online that we can go away and buy these website businesses, different brokers and different marketplaces. The first business that I just shared with you before is from motioninvest.com. Now, motioninvest.com is a great place to go to check out content sites that are anywhere from like a few thousand dollars up to the $50,000, $60,000, $80,000, and $100,000 range for beginners who want to jump into buying an online business. Then you have Flippa.com. They have a lot of great websites for sale as well. There's so many more. Flippa's been around for a lot longer, and there's many different types of businesses on Flippa.com, not just content websites. So check out Flippa.com. Make sure you know how to do due diligence before you actually buy from any of these places as well. And I'm gonna talk about due diligence in a second. Then you can also check out EmpireFlippers.com or FEInternational.com. But if you wanna find some off-market deals, you can go and search in different Facebook groups. Places like niche website builders that are sort of like niche website flipping Facebook groups and flipping website groups and buying online businesses groups. I have my own Facebook group and you can go away and check that out. There should be a link to that in the description as well. And by going away and searching for different Facebook groups, then you can go away and find these businesses that you can buy offline where the seller doesn't need to pay a commission to a broker, and you can get the deal for a little bit cheaper. So the first step to buying a business is actually going away and finding one, and you can go away and research all those places that I've just mentioned. So start there. Step number two is setting goals. So what type of content website do you actually want to buy? Do you want to buy strictly affiliate website where the content site makes majority or all of its revenue from affiliate revenue? And that can be from affiliate partners or affiliate programs. Or do you want majority of the revenue to come from advertising? So ads on the actual website. Or do you want a combination of both? And the most important question is to ask is why? Why do you want affiliate? Or why do you want just ads? Or why do you want a combination or both? You helping yourself understand this really helps you to see what type of business you should be looking for, so you can discard wasting your time on these content sites that aren't within your goals. The next question you want to ask yourself is, how much do you want to spend on your first website business? This is a really important question that everybody asks me. Jared, how much should I spend on my first business? And my go-to answer is, don't go too big too quickly. Now, let me give you an example. Say you've saved $50,000. Okay, so you've got $50,000 in your bank account. What I suggest you don't do is you don't buy a business for $50,000. Maybe start smaller at $40,000 or $30,000. And I say this because you don't want to spend all your savings so you still have a little bit left in your kitty for emergencies. The website you buy actually needs to grow and you want to put money and resources into it, then you actually have some in the kitty as well. Now, I don't think the goal should be to quit work ASAP, as soon as possible. And as much as that's what I do want for people, your goal should actually be to build your wealth without having to go too hard, too quickly. And whilst in doing so, adding so much more stress on your plate. I believe the least amount of stress possible is the best route to take. And if you spend all your money, say you have the $50,000 and you spend all your money on a website for $50,000 and you have nothing left, well, what's that gonna do? That's gonna create stress. You have so much riding on this one business and you don't have anything left in the kitty and you need to make this work because you don't have any contingency plans, right? What this does is it causes you to make decisions, right, in the business and in life based on fear because you've got so much wrapped up into this one business, which is just a recipe for disaster. So don't go too hard, too quick. Start small and work your way up. There's no such thing as getting rich quick here. We want to build wealth slowly over time, the right way with the least amount of stress. And that's what's actually going to make our lifestyle better. If you go in too hard, too quick, you don't have a good foundation and you're stressed out and you're actually not making your life better. You're making your life worse. So set yourself up with having some smart goals without going in too hard, too fast, so you don't make your life harder. Step number three is due diligence. Next, you want to take the business that you're looking at and actually do due diligence on it. Now, due diligence is a fancy word for research to make sure you're not going to buy a lemon. And sure, it's exciting to be able to see that if you buy this website, you're going to make $1,350 per month in passive income. How cool is that? But here's where most people go wrong. What they do is they see the dollar signs and they then picture themselves with this life and how awesome their life will be when they actually own this business and how much money they're gonna make and how quickly they can grow it and then buy another one and rinse and repeat. And what we start to do is we start to build this image, this dream in our head. What we do is we get emotionally attached to that. We want it so bad, right? Because we can see the light at the end of the tunnel and we can picture ourselves quitting our jobs and living our best life. I know this because that was me, right? When I first saw the first business I was looking at, I saw dollar signs. I had dollar signs in my eyes and I could see the light at the end of the tunnel. And all I wanted to do was just buy the business as soon as possible. And what this actually did is it allowed me to not be as diligent when I went to buy the business and I made some mistakes buying my first business. There was things that I missed when I was doing due diligence. And so I believe this mentality is just super dangerous. And it can cause you to buy bad businesses. So the first thing you need to do is to really know how to do due diligence, to make sure you only buy a great investment. And the difference between buying a lemon and a good website is the lemon, it's gonna cost you more money. It's gonna cost you more time and stress. And with a good business, it's gonna make you more money and allow you to have more time and be less stressed. So how do you actually do due diligence? Firstly, if you haven't already, make sure you get my due diligence framework. This is a list of questions that you need to get answers to about the business that you're actually looking at buying to make sure it passes the due diligence test, right? And I created this framework for myself and my clients, and I'm giving it away for free. So what this framework actually does is it takes the guesswork out of buying a website business, okay? You can go away in the description and click a link below in the description somewhere to make sure you can get that due diligence framework. It's on my website, buyingonlinebusinesses.com. And what we actually cover in this due diligence framework is the five main types of due diligence that you need to be doing on any business, okay? First and foremost, marketing. You need to see what sort of marketing they're doing. How are they getting traffic to the site and making sales, okay? So you wanna be working that out. Is it just from Google organic search traffic? Is it from Pinterest? Is it from social media? And it's gonna change depending on the different type of content website you look at. Secondly, SEO. What type of SEO work have they done to the website? Have they done on-page SEO? Have they done off-page SEO, backlink building, internal links, structuring the site, building EAT, which I will mention shortly. And what are they doing with the site to optimize it to get as much traffic as possible to that site from the search engines? Thirdly, you wanna be checking the traffic. Is the traffic trending up? Is it trending down? Is it trending sideways and why? You'll see in the business I'm about to show you that the traffic is trending up and it dipped down a little bit. What you wanna be doing is you wanna be asking questions around why is the traffic going up or is it going down or sideways and why? And equipping yourself with the answers to that why question of why the traffic is actually moving in that direction is going to allow you to either prevent the business from tanking or having the knowledge to grow it. Because if you know how the business is growing or know why that traffic is trending up and the seller tells you why and what they did to do that, then you can replicate and rinse and repeat that and grow the business yourself. Fourthly, we have the financial due diligence. Financial due diligence is going away and getting proof of the income, looking at the accounts, the ad accounts, the affiliate accounts, whatever accounts that are generating the revenue and making sure that that revenue on the profit and loss statement is actually showing up either in the bank account or, you know, correlates and matches up with their merchant account that they're using to, and it could be their affiliate account, could there be their ad account to get their actual revenue. So make sure all that makes sense and get a good list of the expenses they're using to, you know, spend on this business to help it grow as well. So understanding the financials really does help and probably one of the most critical steps. Lastly is competition. Competition is one part of due diligence that nobody really thinks about to do. And I think seeing where the business that we're looking at buying is positioned in the marketplace helps us to see how much growth can we get out of the business and then who's there that's gonna be able to stop us from getting that growth. And can we actually go away and replicate some of the things that the other businesses in the marketplace are doing that this business that we're looking at buying is not doing. So it allows us to identify growth opportunities, which is insanely valuable. And if you follow this due diligence framework that I'm giving you, it'll help you to see the true value of the business that you're actually looking at. So all of my clients that have used this due diligence framework have been able to save thousands to tens of thousands of dollars on the business they bought because it taught them how to know the true value of the business based off this framework. So to get this, click the link in the description. Now let's look at this business, the risks and how to remove them, and then also the growth opportunities it has so you can possibly grow a business like this. But before I do, I wanna ask you, have you ever bought a website business before or even thought about it? Let me know in the comments below. All right, so let me show you how to buy this website or similar websites like yourtechbro.com. This is on motioninvest.com. You can buy this for $50,000 or about $51,000. You can submit an offer. Now, this is under a Dutch listing or a Dutch auction, which means the next price will drop in 18 hours and it will keep dropping $579 every 2 days until the price of this business hits its reserve price. Now let's look at how we can buy this site and some of the things we need to know through doing our due diligence. So here's the overview of the site. It's got about 7,000 keywords almost. The current owner only spends 3 to 4 hours per week on the site and hasn't touched it for the last 2 months, which is really, really cool. Site's making money from Amazon Associates, meaning that it will have tech products they talk about on the actual website. And if people click on those products and go away and purchase them from Amazon, this business will make a healthy affiliate commission from doing so. Here's the proof of the traffic. What you wanna do is you wanna get access to the Google Analytics account. It's great to see some screenshots, which is cool because you can see the proof here, but to have a tinker around and look in there really does help and it gets you information and more data to be able to answer some more serious questions. But here's a breakdown of the traffic, which is great. You can see the traffic has been scaling. I'd be wondering why it's sort of dropped off from July or even August to October, why that has actually dropped off. Is it because the seller hasn't done anything in the last 2 months? So that's a question I'd be asking and making sure you get a decent answer from that as well. Also, I'd be asking here, you can see here's the proof of income. Here's some Amazon screenshots. I'd be trying to get a video, to get video proof from them if you can, to get, you know, because screenshots, I'm not saying they're going to be butchered or anything like this. I know the owners of Motion Invest, they're very trustworthy people. But it is good to get a bit more data and see a bit more of the proof of income. Now, as you can see, the site has been growing, and they had two really good months in March 2020 and April 2021. You'd want to be asking why. Why did they have really good months? Well, in even these 3 months, March to May, why is it they had really, you know, three really good months and then it started to decline? Is it because there's some season in this business? I dare say not with tech products, but you want to be checking that as well when you're doing due diligence. Next, you want to be looking at how much search traffic it's getting, the backlinks, and you do want to do some backlink analysis or a backlink audit, I would say. So this has a UR rating of 23 and a DR rating of 2.4. So the main rating is very low. It doesn't really have much authority, this site, which means you'd need to really build that up. So there would be some risks with EAT around this business. There's 157 referring backlinks that are do follow. Okay, so there's a bunch that aren't do follow and probably a lot that aren't very relevant links. So you would probably want to do a backlink audit, get Ahrefs or SEMrush to do that. They do have a backlink report here that you can check out as well. Site Buddy analysis, this basically helps you see what sort of like the Amazon affiliate links that are either broken or not getting enough revenue, all that sort of stuff. So Site Buddy was started by John Gillham, who was a founder of Motion Invest. Then go through the Q&A with the seller. I won't do this on this video with you right now, but go through the Q&A. And then to finish off due diligence, what I suggest is if you haven't already, like I mentioned before, make sure you get my due diligence framework so you can ask all the questions you need to ask about any business, this one in particular, get the answers to those questions. And that's gonna help you make a more informed and a more equipped decision to see whether business is a good investment or not. So I showed you some of the risks with this business. The opportunities I would say is putting ads on the site to make more revenue from the website. Also creating more content, probably better content, creating some EAT, which is expertise, authority, and trust, which is gonna help with SEO and get better ranking so you can build up that domain rating that we talked about here. And I'd also be building an email list so you can control more of the traffic that you send to the site from your email list. And you can also make affiliate offers as well. Maybe not through Amazon, but through other affiliate products if you do link up and get some diversification through joining up with other affiliate partners, not affiliate programs, but affiliate partners and retailers, because you can bargain and work out better deals for affiliate commissions for you to make more money in affiliate commissions rather than just going with an affiliate program. You can find your own affiliate partners. So that's what I'd be doing in terms of growing this business and the opportunities that I see within this one. That's it, guys. YouTube watcher, what's up? It's Jared Krause. And if you have watched this video up until now, please smash the like button. Also, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're doing super good. And I also want to ask you, please consider subscribing because my exploration on YouTube is about to explode. I'm talking stories, polls, more amazing content, more surprise and delight. And this is the time to subscribe. So I hope to see you on the next video. Bye.
Hey, YouTube watcher. If you thought that video was good, you should check out this video here on the two best types of websites beginners should buy. Or check out my playlist on how I made my first 100K from buying websites and how to do due diligence. Check it out. It's an awesome playlist. You'll enjoy it.